Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the CDCS sneak peek. This is a 30-minute sneak peek of the Certified Data Center Specialist course, and I will be your presenter for the next 30 minutes. During the presentation, in case you have any questions, feel free to drop these into the chat window. At the end of the presentation, at the end of the sneak peek, we have the ability to actually answer the questions. And in case you have any questions, you can also send us an email, and the email address will be listed at the end of the sneak peek in one of the final slides. Now, good day. My name is Marco van Ginck. I am currently located in Holland. I will be your presenter for this sneak peek. I have 19 years of experience in designing, operating, and also building data centers. And during the training, I also tend to share a lot of experiences and practical examples on how to operate and design data centers. Now, the CDCS is a very interesting course for this. So in the next 25 minutes, 30 minutes, we will see a couple of slides coming from the course. Now, this is the agenda. First, we talk a little bit about EPI, the company. We talk about the training framework, the different trainings that we actually provide all over the world. We have the CDCS preview, which is about 20 pages. And at the end of the final page of the CDCS, we talk about the data center career planning tool, which is a very useful tool, which I will explain to you and which is also free to use. So you can always use it through our website. And then we have some time for the questions and the answers. Now, who is EPI? EPI is a big company. It was founded more than 30 years ago in the UK, 1987, 31 years ago. We moved to Singapore in 1999, and we have a global coverage by having 9 offices all around the world. And we work through local partners in more than 60 countries. So we have a huge footprint, and we provide very interesting services. We are the biggest company, the world market leader in providing data center training and also audits. And the audits are based on the American TIA 942 standards, which we will also talk about in a lot more detail in the CDCS core. We perform design evaluation, audit certification, and professional training. And the training program is designed in different scopes, which we'll see in one of the next slides as well. Now, we have been awarded multiple times in the past couple of years. We are always also being mentioned in many publications, specific industry related magazines, and our founder and CEO, Mr. Edward van Leent, is often being asked for performing interviews and also quotes for that matter. We are official training partner for several companies such as the Data Center World, providing exhibitions and also Data Center Forum. So we are quite well represented all over the world. Now, this is our EPI data center training framework. And obviously, today we focus on the CDCS, which is part of the design and build scope. We also have an operations scope, which involves a certified data center facility and operations manager. We have a course called CDRP, the risk professional, and also the CDMS, the migration specialist. And we have a dedicated scope to the standards. We have our own TIA 942 standards training, which is called the CTDC. Certified TIA 942 Design Consultant, which is a 3-day course. Now, let's focus on this part of our framework, the design and build. Today, we will be talking about the CDCS, but we also have the CDCP, which is a 2-day course where we talk about how to run and operate a data center fairly high level. We go a little bit deeper into the technical aspect, talking about electrical infrastructure, also a lot about the power infrastructure, but this is a very interesting course for any site engineer or floor manager. Now, the CDCS is a 3-day course, and this is something that we talk about today. And after the CDCS, you can attend and sign in for the CDCE, which is the Certified Data Center Expert course, which is more a workshop. Very interested as well, interesting as well, but if you have any questions about the other courses, feel free to send us an email or to serve to our website. Now, the Certified Data Center Specialist course is a 3-day course, which involves a lot of different disciplines and aspects that we need to know and need to be trained for in order to be able to run a decent, stable, and efficient data center. Now, as mentioned, this is a three-day course. Here you can find the agenda. On the first day, we talk about the data center lifecycle. And from some of these chapters, some slides will be shown in the next 25 minutes as well. The data center lifecycle, we talk about the different standards and the different guidelines that are able, that are basically available on the market. We talk about the building considerations, how to design a raised floor system, and eventually also a concealed or suspended ceiling. And we talk about power. Now, the power chapter is quite comprehensive. We have a couple of slides coming up from this chapter as well, where we actually talk a lot in detail about the different power infrastructure related components. And also capacity management is obviously a key part of power infrastructure. Now, on the second day, we talk about electromagnetic fields, which is very important, We have a slide coming up in the next couple of minutes, and we talk about the different cooling systems in very much detail. And not only the mechanical cooling systems, but in the CDCS, we also talk about the direct or the indirect free cooling systems that are often being used all over the world nowadays. And this can be applied for sustainability and also to save a lot of money on power consumption. Now we have the fire suppression chapter, where we talk about many different fire suppression systems. And this is not only the gas-based systems, but this is also, for example, a water mist or a oxygen depriving system. And they all have a certain pro and con. And it obviously depends on the total design of the data center and also the construction and limit of the building. Now, installing a scalable network cabling system is obviously very important. This is a big chapter where we talk about many details. And again, one slide in the next couple of slides, and we'll be talking about this chapter as well. On the third day, we talk about environmental considerations, because efficiency obviously is very important. Also human health. Think about the amount of noise that you're allowed to work in, the amount of noise in a particular area. The ambient temperature nowadays, the temperature inside the computer room tends to be a lot hotter than like 15 or 20 years ago. And this could actually become a health issue. So we talk about this. Then on the third day, we are able to actually run the exam. And for the CDCS, this exam consists out of multiple questions, obviously. Multiple choice answers are being given. And on the third day, you are basically able to run through the exam. Now, the exam will be accredited by Exyn, which is a global company as well. And if you pass the exam, you will be provided with a certificate, and that's a proof of your knowledge. So this is obviously very interesting. Excuse me. Good. Now, the first chapter is the data center lifecycle in the CDCS. And the data center lifecycle is obviously very important, because the first question we need to ask ourselves will be, what is the cost of downtime? And if we know what the cost of downtime are, then we also are more able to determine what is the availability level of the data center that we're going to build or retrofit or expand, for that matter. This is important. This is often being forgotten. And we talk about different rating levels, which actually give us an opportunity to guarantee a certain availability. And this is something that we talk about in the next slide as well. And the data center lifecycle is obviously a big process, overall process covering many years as well. First of all, we have the design part, and we have to determine the scope. Are we going to expand a current data center, or going to build a new data center or a computer floor because we change our business, for example? This involves the selection of a project team. We have to acquire a budget, and not only for the build of the data center, but we also need to have a running budget in order to keep the data center up and running, which is normally is a specific percentage of the building budget as well. And we have to be able to select the different vendors and the different equipment for that matter. Now, the implementation obviously takes a lot of time as well. First, we have to build the building, or we have to buy or rent an existing building. And then we have to perform the fit out, the actual build and conversion to a computer room and a data center. And this involves many aspects that we will talk about in the CDCS. Now, the continuous process will be to operate the data center every single day, 8,760 hours a year. We have to have full control over the data center. And by operating the data center, we also have to implement efficiency improvements in order to save a little bit of money on power consumption, for example, and also because it's better for the environment. Now, eventually the data center can be phased out if we're going to change our business. So we're going to consolidate multiple smaller sites inside a bigger data center. Then we have to run through the retire chapter. And this could actually be a partially illegal thing as well. Now, in the second chapter of the CDCS, we talk about the different guidelines and the standards that we refer to in all of our courses, which is the TIA 942 standard. Now, the TIA standard is issued by the American National Standard Institute, and this is quite similar to the European ISO. Now, the standard is obviously a document. It's about 100 pages that you can download. And inside the standard, a lot of details are being given how to design and build a data center. Now, to be able to run an efficient and available data center, we have to focus on four disciplines. And we often refer to it as being team: telecommunication, electrical, architectural, like the actual build of the building and the construction, and the M for mechanical, being the cooling infrastructure. Now, if any of those disciplines are becoming unavailable or less available due to certain circumstances or lack of capacity, then obviously it could have an impact on your business. Now, by adopting the TIA 942 standards, we can determine what the level of availability needs to be and how we actually have to design and build a data center. This is being expressed in four different levels, and it's called rating 1, rating 2, rating 3, or rating 4. And obviously, the higher the rating, the more available the data center will eventually become, because we talk about multiple feeds, multiple paths, multiple components, eventually redundant components, and so on. And the TIA is the most comprehensive standard that is available, because it covers all the four disciplines: electrical, mechanical, architectural, and telecommunication, as you can see. And the good thing about the TIA standard is also that it's being updated and revised every 1 or 2 years, and therefore it's basically adjusted according to the market requirements. Now, in the CDCS, we talk about building locations. What are we going to do? Are we going to build the building, or are we going to lease or buy an existing building? This has to do with the time to market for your service, but it also has to do about the potential risk factors in the surrounding. So if we're going to buy an existing building, then obviously we have to assess the current risks, such as highways, airports, power stations, and so on. We go into these details a lot in the CDCS, where we also talk about fire resistance. We talk about vapor barriers in order to provide thermal stability inside the walls, and so on. Now, on the power infrastructure chapter of the CDCS, we go a lot into the details of the power infrastructure and its components. In this slide, you can actually see a single line diagram, which is something like an S-built drawing of your power distribution panels. And we go to some of these examples where we talk about components such as circuit breakers. We talk about isolators. We talk about fuses, breakers, residual current devices, and so on. And obviously, power is a very important part about the data center, because if we lose power, then obviously the data center will become unavailable. We also have to figure out how to reduce the single points of failure. And in the CDCS, we talk about this and also having some practical examples for that matter. Now, we talk about the specific configuration of the electrical components. Well, it needs to be configured in a particular safety. Think about relays. Think about power ratings of your fuses and your breakers. Discrimination studies needs to be performed, and this is something that we cover in the CDCS power infrastructure chapter. We also talk about different UPS systems. So we go into the details of the specific static UPS systems, which use a lot of power batteries to store power. And we talk about the dynamic rotating UPS systems, which store power in the flywheel, in the kinetic wheels. Now, they all have certain pros and cons. And then we go into this a little bit deeper. Now, one of the interesting parts of the CDCS is that this training actually provides assessments. So we talk about different formulas, and during the 3 days of course, the 3 course days, we also get to work with these formulas. So we have to use the calculator, and even in the exam, we need to be able to use the formula, to remember the formula, and to calculate particular values. Now, some of these assessments include the selection of the type of battery and the amount of batteries that you need to have in order to store up to a certain amount of power. But it also includes a formula for calculating fire suppression agent, how many kilograms of gas do we need to have, and also a formula how we can actually calculate the attenuation level in order to reduce electromagnetic fields. And this is one part of the CDS, one slide, calculating the battery banks, and where we actually go into these details a lot, which makes it easier for you, for example, to determine how many batteries do we need, why do we have a couple of hundred of those batteries, and how long can we actually take power out of the batteries, for what autonomy time, what running time can we actually create. Now, another slide on the CDCS is the EMF, electromagnetic fields, which is basically radiation, which is all around us. We talk about two different levels of radiation and also a formula that we have to remember for the exam. And everything that's transporting power does create EMF, electromagnetic fields, and specifically the components that transport the most amount of power, such as the one that you see on the screen, the power transformer, but also the UPSs. Now, in the cooling infrastructure chapter, we talk about different cooling systems. We talk about chilled water systems. We talk about DX, direct expansion systems. We talk about free cooling systems, and also the different components, such as the evaporators, the dry coolers, the condensers, the maximum pipe length pumps. And this is definitely very interesting because nowadays, the temperature tends to rise inside the computer room because IT equipment is more capable of running at a higher temperature, but we still need to have enough mechanical cooling capacity in order to protect the IT load from basically getting too hot, and then eventually it will be switched off. We talk about temperature and humidity measurements, and not only temperature is important, but also air volume. And in this slide, you can actually see which part of the data center you can measure and which can also back up your service level agreements. Now, for the fire suppression system, we talk about the different fire suppression systems, like the halocarbon gas or the inert gas. They both have certain pros and cons, depends on a particular design of your data center. And we also talk about water mist and oxygen debriefing systems, being systems which will reduce the amount of oxygen inside the air, which will prevent even a fire to actually start happening, or it can actually extinguish a fire. This is a big chapter. Obviously, it also includes an assessment, so we get to calculate using a particular formula. And during the calculation, we are also made aware of two particularly interesting things that we have to take into consideration when we're going to determine how much kilograms of gas we need to have. So quite a big chapter, and obviously it goes a lot into detail as well. Now we have the networking and the scalable networking chapter, the TIA 942 network cable logical architecture. This is an example how to create your telecommunication path inside the computer room. And obviously the TIA 942 is originally a telecommunication infrastructure standard for data center. So it has a lot of details on how to design and build a decent logical architecture. Now, this also depends on your rating level, because obviously the rating level depends on the availability of the data center itself. So starting from a rating 3, we need to have multiple feeds, and this is also the case for your telecommunication infrastructure. So we talk about the different entrance rooms. We talk about different main distribution areas. We talk about horizontal cabling, intermediate distribution zones, a lot of different spaces that we need to have. And especially when the data center becomes bigger, when we operate a big data center with a lot of clients, a lot of telecommunication providers and IP carriers, this is definitely something that needs to be designed and built very well. Because if we lose the uplinks to our data center, if we lose the connections, then eventually the data center will be quote unquote down, and it might have an impact on your business and your business services. Now, one of the last chapters of the CDCS involves cleaning the data center. And this is a slide that comes from this particular chapter as well. And it's very hard to keep the data center and the computer room clean, especially when we operate a computer room where a lot of people have access to, such as a co-location provider or for a big enterprise. Then every time when somebody enters the room, we carry in a lot of contamination and mainly dust, because our clothes are an easy carrier for dust. And if you have a lot of people walking in, then dust might be a risk factor for the data center. Now, this is the case for almost every single computer room or data center. Dust is killing, because dust will insulate your components, and therefore the heat cannot adequately be removed from your IT components. So eventually it might actually shorten the life cycle of your component, which makes it a challenge, because how can you actually guarantee the availability of your service then? Also, any solid corrosive components, from galvanized steel or from steel, think about corrosion. And liquids, which could either be direct water, which comes from the cooling systems, for example, but it could also vaporized water, such as high humidity levels, or even humidity from sea. Salt water is something which is definitely very difficult to protect against. This also involves your cooling systems, because if we use a direct free cooling system, then it would mean that we are taking in outside air directly inside the computer room, including all the contamination, the humidity levels, and so on. So applying proper filter sections is definitely very important. Now, the efficiency chapter talks about the different efficiency levels that we can actually achieve. And there are a lot of guidelines which you can use all over the world. One of the well-known ones is the PUE factor, the power usage effectiveness, in which we can actually display the efficiency of the data center. Now, this strongly depends on the country and the ambient temperature, obviously, because not in all countries you can actually use outside air to cool down your IT equipment, especially when you have an outside air temperature of, let's say, 40 degrees C, then this would not be an option. But going green often has an impact on the choice of your cooling infrastructure systems, because quite often these systems consume a lot of power. Now, if we actually are going to apply outside air cooling, free cooling, then we can actually decrease the amount of power consumption, and eventually our efficiency level will go up as well. And in many countries and even cities nowadays, it's the case that you have to prove the local government that your newly built data center will reach a certain efficiency level, and otherwise the local government might actually prevent you from start building because they do tends to want an efficient data center nowadays. Now, there are different methods on doing so, and in this chapter we also calculate the PUE factor. We have a formula for that you obviously have to remember for your exam as well, and not only for your exam but also for your daily practice. Now, these were some slides from the CDCS. Obviously the CDCS has many, many slides, but we made a selection to give you an idea about the level of detail that we talk about inside the CDCS 3-day course. Now, we have another interesting tool which you can use on our website. It's free, so this is good. And this is the Data Center Career Planning Tool. Now, if you use the tool, you can actually select the job that you currently have. And the tool will tell you which competences you need to have in order to run a decent job. Now, it will also select which training programs or which courses from EPI might actually be of any interest to you. And the tool has another nice feature, because the tool will give you the opportunity to also select the job that you want to go to. So if you want to go to a different job within the company, then you can actually select a job and the tool will automatically tell you which other competences you need to have. And if you elect these competences, obviously it will also select the different courses provided by EPI and its local partners, which might be of your interest. Now, the interesting thing about the DCPT is that it will actually provide you with a personalized report. So it will list your name. And so this could be a little bit easier to convince HR as well to allocate some training budget for you. It's definitely interesting. It's free. You can find it on our website on epi-ap.com/DCPT. Eventually, if you just search, go to our website, epi-ap.com, you will find it automatically, and it will also provide you with a lot of other interesting information as well, such as the DCOS, which is the Data Center Operation Standard that you can actually sign in for. Now, feel free to ask any questions in the chat window. You should be able to see a chat window in your software, in your interface, where you can actually list your questions. This is a 30-minute slot, so we still have some minutes left to actually answer the questions live, like right now. And in case the slot will be shut down, or you have a very specific question or a big question, feel free to send us an email. And you can send your questions to sales@epi-ap.com. The address that you can find on the slide. And if this involves a technical question, then obviously it can be forwarded to a technical a trainer or an auditor from EPI within EPI, and maybe it will eventually end up in my mailbox. That is possible. Also, in case you have any questions about the other training courses from EPI, feel free to send an email, and we will be happy to inform you about the possibilities and to tell you a little bit more in detail about the different training programs that we have on the market. And again, we have a huge footprint. We train through local partners, so there's a fair chance that you can actually sign up for a training program at a local partner. So this will prevent you from having to travel a lot, for that matter. Any questions about the CDCS or the DCPT, maybe, or a different course? And if there are no further questions, then I would like to thank you for your time. This is a sneak preview of the CDCS, a 30-minute preview this was. And again, if you require more information about the different chapters and the different information that we talk about in the CDCS, feel free to search our websites, to visit our website, or to send us an email so we can inform you by email directly. So I received another question, which is a very good question. Thank you very much. Do we require to take the CDCP first prior to take the CDCS? And this is indeed the case. So we first have to run through the CDCP, which is a two-day course, in order to be able to sign in for the CDCS. Now again, the CDCP is a course which involves all the different aspects of the data center as well, but it doesn't go into the particular parts in detail. This is specifically where the CDCS comes in. Now the CDCS is somewhat like a technical course. About 60%, 60%, we talk about technical aspects such as the cooling infrastructure, the power infrastructure, the different UPS systems, the different diesel generators, and also the testing sequences and so on. But first you have to sign in for the CDCP. That is correct. Yeah, thank you very much for asking. And the CDCS is definitely interesting for any IT engineer, facility engineer, floor manager, data center owner, data center operator, because again, it involves all four disciplines that we need to have in order to run a decent data center. Team, telecommunication, electrical, architectural, and mechanical. So by attending either the CDCP and the CDCS or and the CDCS, you actually get to know what your colleague is doing every single day. Because quite often, the company is divided into two departments, being the IT department and the facility department, and they both have to be able to work together. Because if the facility department doesn't do a good job, then obviously the IT department will have difficulties in operating a decent IT environment. And it also works the other way around. You have to work together, and by attending either the CDCP or the CDCS, you get to know what your colleague is doing, what his responsibilities are within the company, and that we all have to run a decent job in order to keep the data center up and running. Are there any more questions about the CDCP, CDCS? And again, if you have any questions, feel free to send us an email. For now, again, I want to thank you for your time. Thank you for your questions as well. And maybe I'll be seeing you in one of the next courses or virtual trainings as well. Thank you very much. Have a great day.